Good morning, student. Today we are going to know something about linear equation in two variables. So first of all, we know what is linear equation in two variables. Linear means the maximum power of, like linear polynomial, the maximum power of the variable is 1. So here linear means the maximum power of variable in expression is 1. Equation means when two algebraic expressions shows an equality is called equation. Two variables, it means the equation contains two variables. So the linear equation in two variables means an equation which contains two variables and the maximum power of variable is 1. The general form of linear equation in two variable is ax plus by plus c equals to 0. Equals to shows an equality. The maximum power of the running variable is x and y. This expression, this equation contains two variables x and y. The maximum power of variable is x is 1 and the maximum power of variable y is 1. So the maximum power of variable in this equation is 1. So equality equals to 0. That's why it is linear equation in two variables. So this is the general form of linear equation in two variables. Graphically, when you draw the graph of this equation, you get a straight line. Always you get a straight line by drawing the graph for this equation. The graph of this equation, it is straight line. It means this equation has infinite number of solutions. If we have two lines, if we have two lines in a plane, either it may be like this, intersecting line, either it may be a parallel line or coincident line. One line is overlapped to other. So this is the possibilities of two lines lie in a plane. And it may be intersecting line, it may be coincident line, and it may be a parallel line. So the equation, so the solution of the these three types of equation is, well, see here, in parallel line there is no point of intersection, that's why it has no solution. In coincident line, we see that there is many common points, that's why it has infinite number of solutions. And in case of intersecting line, we have only one solution. It is called unique solution. So for parallel line, there is no solution. For intersecting line, there is unique solution. And for infinite number of solution is for coincident line. So we have, if in a plane two lines lie, there is three types of possibilities here. So when two lines, if the two lines having at least one common solution, two lines in which at least one common solution, that is called consistent line. So here you see that in intersecting line or in coincident line, we have in one solution or more than one solution, that's why this comes under the consistent equation, which has no solution. So the lines having at least one solution, it's consistent. That in case of parallel lines, there is no solution, the That's why it is inconsistent. It is called inconsistent. So in case of no solution, the line is inconsistent. In case of intersecting line, unique solution. In case of intersecting line, okay, that is unique solution, consistent line. In case of infinite so number of solutions, that is coincident line, consistent. So the inconsistent, the infinite, coincident line, and the intersecting line comes. And in case of no inconsistent, there line, there is parallel line. There is no any common solution. So we have two pair of equation: a1x plus b1y plus c1. This is for the line one. And a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. So this is the general form of linear equation in two variable for two lines. If lines are consistent, if lines are consistent, it means it has either unique solution or infinite solution. So without drawing graph, we can find that by the coefficients of this equation, the line is consistent or inconsistent. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, a1 is the coefficient of x in first equation and a2 is the coefficient of x in y in second equation. B1 is the coefficient of y in first equation, b2 is the coefficient of y in second equation. If the ratio of a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then the line will be consistent. Consistent and has unique solution. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2, that it is consistent as well as infinite solution. And if a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2, it is inconsistent and no solution. So without drawing graph, only by the relationship of coefficients or ratio of the coefficients, we can find that the line will be consistent or inconsistent. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then the line will be consistent and has unique solution. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2, then the line will be consistent and has infinite number of solutions. It means coincident line. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2, it means it is inconsistent and has no solution and parallel line. You can find the solution of the equation by different methods. First one, by graphically we can find the solution. Second one is by using substitution method. Next one is by elimination method and by cross multiplication. So there is four methods. By four methods we can find the solution of the equation. If there is any solution, we can find by using graphical method or by substitution method, elimination method and cross multiplication method. So first you go through the linear equation in two variable. In next video I will discuss the methods to find the solution of the equation. So that's all. Thank you.